हेलो माय डियर फ्रेंड्स एंड चाणक्य फ्रेटर्निटी, आई कृष्णा कुमार वेलकम यू ऑल टू टुडेज टॉपिक ऑफ डिस्कशन, पॉजिटिव पे सिस्टम। वी विल बी एनालाइजिंग दैट हाउ दिस न्यूज़ वुड बी इम्पॉर्टेंट फॉर द यूपीएससी सिविल सर्विसेज एग्जाम एंड हाउ इट कैन बेनिफिट द सिविल सर्विसेज एस्पिरेंट्स। पॉजिटिव पे सिस्टम, वी विल बी डिस्कशिंग दैट वॉट इज दिस पॉजिटिव पे सिस्टम एंड वॉट वॉज द नीड टू इंट्रोड्यूस दिस सिस्टम। बट we have discussed this topic in our earlier videos on HDI and PMWANI. Please watch these videos to get over the concept. Okay, but let me know that what is this image is telling you. We will be discussing that what this image is about and what is the purpose of this image here. Actually, it shows that some person is using mobile and sending some data. Okay, we will be discussing this image, but after in the end of the video. So we will be discussing that why it is in news and what is the context of this discussion. What is the context of positive pay system, positive pay mechanism? What is positive pay system? Okay, recently banks had witnessed a rise in frauds involving high value checks. Okay, so recently there was a high amount of frauds in the value of checks that was drawn to the banks. On January 1, 2021, the RBI will introduce the positive pay system for check transactions above 50,000. Okay, and as per RBI Governor Shaktikant Das, the positive pay system is introduced to enhance the safety of check payment for all the checks of value rupees 50,000 and above. So this system is being introduced to enhance the safety of check payments. Okay, and to reduce the level of frauds. So this system will cover the 50,000 cap and it will be covering approximately 20% transactions by volume and 80% by value. So what is positive pay mechanism and why it is being introduced? So the positive pay mechanism is being developed by the NPCI, National Payments Corporation of India. NPCI has also developed one UPI. Can you please tell me what is that in the comment section? Okay, so to reduce check related frauds, the Reserve Bank of India has asked banks to implement a system called Positive Pay from January 2021. This system will add an extra layer of security to the high value of checks. Okay, and Positive Pay system is a fraud detection tool. What it is? It is a fraud detection tool adopted by banks to protect customers against forged, altered or counterfeit checks. It will be cross-check all details. It will cross-check all details of the check issued before funds are encashed by the beneficiary. This system will cross-check all the details of the check issued before funds and encashed by the beneficiary. And in case of a mismatch, the check is sent back to the issuer for the examination. So you can see that this is the concept to reduce the frauds. Okay, by following such a system, the bank knows of a check being drawn by the customer even before it is deposited by the beneficiary into his or her account. So under this process, the issuer of the check submits through channels like SMS, mobile app, internet banking and ATM. Okay, these are all electronic mediums. So the issuer of check will transmit certain information or certain minimum details of the check, like date of the check, name of the beneficiary or payee details, or what is the amount of that check. So he will transmit that information electronically to the drawee bank. So what is drawee bank? Drawee bank is the bank that cashes your check. Okay, drawee bank is the bank that cashes your check. Okay, so details of which are cross-checked by the check truncation system. So what is this check truncation system? Actually, check truncation system is an interface. Check truncation system is an interface. Interface which process and verify the details of the check. Okay, so now you can see in this slide that how check truncation system works. So first it will collect checks from the bank branch, and then it will send the bundle of checks to the service bank. After that, it will store the scanned image of check and other relevant data, okay? And then service bank will send this data to the clearinghouse, okay? And then clearinghouse will assess this data and determine a settlement amount. And further, the clearinghouse transmits the data to the drawee bank. Who is drawee bank? Drawee bank is the bank that cashes your check. And through this clearinghouse interface, this data is accepted by the drawee bank. And after that, your payment will be processed to your account. Or if the information is wrong, then the check would be rejected, and the return file through return clearing session would be given. Okay. So, what are the benefits of this check truncation system? There are actually two types of authorities or two types of individuals that are involved in the benefits. First one is customer, and second one is bank. Both are being benefited from this check truncation system. So for customers or for the users of the bank, there is no fear of loss of check in transit, okay? And faster credit of funds will be ensured by this check truncation system. This system is more secure and there is lesser chances of fraud. And through the check truncation system, we can ensure multi-city checks that could be cleared in the same day. And as banks are also the authority in this, as banks are also the beneficiaries under this check truncation system, so it would also benefit the banks. How it would benefit banks? It will reduce the cost of transit and errors due to manual work, okay? Then reconciliation will be easy and faster. The time taken to clear the checks will be shorter. There is operational efficiency as it would be maintained by the central system. And after that, it will reduce the risk, okay? So we will be discussing that how does this positive pay mechanism will work. Under positive pay feature, the issuer have to first share the details of the check, like what can be the details. Details can be the check number, okay, date of the check, name of the payee, account number, or what is the amount, and the likes through his or her net banking account. Okay, along with these details, the issuer or the person who has issued the check has to send the front and reverse side of the check, okay, before handing it over to the beneficiary. So when the beneficiary submits the check for the encashment to the banks, the details would be compared by the bank through the positive pay system. And if the details will match, then only the check will be honored. However, in the case of mismatch, the check is referred to the issuer. In this way, any check where any sort of fraud has happened cannot be cleared at all, and hence depositors' money can be protected. So, what kind of checks or details to how much amount the checks can come under the ambit of positive pay? So, the banks will enable the new system for all account holders issuing checks for amounts of rupees 50,000 and above. So, checks up to the amount of rupees 50,000 can be in the ambit of positive pay system. And while availing of this facility is at the discretion of account holder. Banks may consider making it mandatory in case of checks for amount of rupees 50,000 and above. It depends on the bank that either they want to make it mandatory for the checks above the amount of 5 lakh. Okay. For banks, it would be mandatory to apply this positive pay system for the value of checks that are above rupees 5 lakh. Okay. And there is such instance that ICICI Bank has been using this positive pay system since 2016 for all checks, irrespective of the amount, via its iMobile application. Okay. So what are the advantages of positive pay mechanism? The first and the foremost advantage is fraud prevention. After that, positive pay works as an insurance for customers. If an account holder shares the details of the issued check and his bank still clears a fraudulent check, the onus is on the bank and not on the customer. this is how it will work like a insurance for the customer. So typically hota kya hai, typically when a fraudulent transaction happens through checks, it is difficult to put the onus either on the customer or the banks, and banks don't take any responsibility if the signature and check are left leave are genuine. So customers got irritated and they think that banks are not doing enough. So this is how the positive pay mechanism will benefit the banks as well as customers. So even if your bank doesn't make the positive pay system mandatory, opt for it. You should have to opt for it to avoid falling victim to the banking fraud. RBI has already told banks to create adequate awareness among their customers on features of the positive pay system through SMS, displays in branches, at ATMs, okay, and on their websites of the bank, through internet banking and various other mechanisms. So RBI has given banks this responsibility to publish the positive pay mechanism in the larger domain of the public. So concluding this discussion, we can say that in a nutshell, we can say that positive pay mechanism is a check fraud detection tool. Okay, it is used to control or reduce the frauds related to the check. Okay, and it is a service that matches the account number, check number, okay, that and check presented for the payment, it and the check presented for the bank, so that the check frauds can be reduced. How does it work? First, the issuer will issue the check, okay, and then the check data would be sent to the bank through e-platforms or to the electronic platforms. Now this data of the check would be verified, okay, by which bad checks would be shorted out from the system, and the issuer will be notified that some malicious activity has been happened over his check. So bad checks would be returned and there would be reduction in frauds. So how one can participate in positive pay mechanism? You have to find out what your bank's positive pay program is, and after that you should have to look for a software solution designed to submit the data to your bank, and after that you just have to configure the software for use. Okay, so overall this is the concept of positive pay mechanism, as well as how it would be leading to reduction of check frauds. So in the beginning of this discussion, I have shown you this image, that how you perceiving this. So now we would be discussing that what is the importance of this image. Actually, this image is nothing, but it tells you that there is a user that is using his mobile to transmit his check data, related check data, to the banks, so that he could confirm or assure that his check would not be used maliciously. Okay, so thank you very much for listening this discussion. I hope you all are working hard to ensure your dream come true. Okay, so thank you very much. Keep learning, keep watching.
Don't forget to like, share and subscribe to our channel, and press the bell icon to never miss an update.